हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर नाजीम अहमद, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री। वेलकम टू दिस ऑनलाइन क्लास। इन दिस प्रीवियस वीडियो वी डिस्कस अबाउट कम्युनिकेटिव इंग्लिश ऑफ पार्ट वन, इन विच लिसनिंग एंड स्पीकिंग, फॉलोड बाय दिस वीडियो। लेट अस बिगिन। Listening and speaking. First introduction. When we learn any language, there are four skills that we need for complete communication. So there are four skills that we need for complete communication. Otherwise, it will be very difficult. So these are called the four language skills. Skill number one is listening. Skill number two is speaking. Skill number three is reading. And skill number four is writing. Please remember, listening, speaking, reading and writing. These are all the four skills for complete communication. These are called the four language skills. When we learn our native language, we usually learn to listen first, then to speak, then to read, and finally we try to write. Is it not? So when we learn our native language, we usually learn to listen first, then to speak, then to read, and finally we try to write. As you can see, listening is the first skill. Listening is the first language skill. It is perhaps the most important skill of all, the basis for the other three. Okay, so listening is the very important one. Listening is the first skill, followed by the other three. The four language skills are related to each other in two ways. Number one, the direction of communication in or out. Remember, please make note of it. The direction of communication in or out. The second one is the method of communication, whether speaking or writing, spoken or written. Okay, it is very, very important one. So the method of communication, how we communicate, whether it is a public speaking or in the form of writing article, that is very essential. So it should be spoken or written. That is the method. What method we are following? Input is sometimes called reception, and output is called production. Please make note of it. Input communication, that is direct, is called reception, whereas the output, otherwise it is called as production. Understand? Please make note of it. Now, written and spoken. Here we have input and output. Input, that is reception, that is listening, whereas output, the smiley symbol shows that is a production or speaking. Now the next criteria is return, in forms of it may be reading or this writing. Please remember, this chart is very simple and easy and very important one. So it is clearly given what is input, what is output. Input is reception, that is listening, and in terms of written reading, whereas output is production, speaking, and followed by writing. Okay, please make note of it. Now teaching listening. Children in an English language class will listen to a great variety of texts, but above all to their teacher talking, singing, chanting, telling stories. Please remember, children, kids in an English language classes will listen to a great variety of texts, but above all to their teacher talking, singing, chatting, telling stories. Teacher often talk a lot in the target language because they provide their language input, is it not? Remember, in classroom what happened? Teacher will give the lecture, often talk a lot in the great language because they provide in the language input. This helps children to get used to the intention patterns and the sounds of the language. That is very important. This helps the children to get used to the intonation patterns and the sounds of the language. Teacher talk and comment and what is going on as they point out to pictures in the book or on the classroom wall, or as they mime something, is it not? In generally what happened? So teacher talk and comment. In generally what happened in the classroom? Teacher is commenting or what is going on in this picture on the blackboard. They are explaining in detail, or as the mime something, he is showing something, that is demo or instruction in the practical in the classrooms. By employing a variety of creative exercise, teachers can help students develop strong listening skills that will aid them throughout their academic careers, is it not? By employing a variety of creative exercise, lot of exercise is assigning to you, and also the teachers help the students to develop the strong skill listening, strong listening skills that will aid, that will help them throughout their academic careers, is it not? So by means of exercise, by means of assignment, teachers is helping us to develop our listening skills that will help throughout our career. It will helpful for our future. Now it has been estimated that adults spends almost half their communication time listening, and students may receive as much as 90% of their in school information through listening to instructors and to one another. In generally what happened in the classroom, teachers or your lecturers, professors will give on, will going on giving the lectures. So nearly 90% only you are receiving the message, receiving the information through listening from the instructors or and one to another. Now next top subtopic is listening aspects of difficulties. Listening aspects of difficulty. Listening is an active skill and there are many factors that contribute to its difficulty. What are they? The type and length of the text the children listen to, the familiarity of the person who they are listening to. Okay, first one is the type and length of the text. Second one is the familiarity of the person who they are listening to. Not all listening is the same, is it not? Casual greetings, for example, require different sort of listening capability than do academic lectures. Language learning requires international listening that employs strategies for identifying sound and making meaning from them. So remember, not all listening is the same. Not all listening is the same. Similarly, listening involves a sender. Listening involves a sender, a person, radio, television, message receiver, that listener. So listening involves a sender through the message and a receiver, that is person to person, radio, television. These are all comes under these things. Listening strategies are equal to, or techniques or activities that contribute directly to the comprehension and recall of listening input. So remember, please I repeat once again, what is listening strategies or techniques? So this is the techniques or activities that contribute directly to the comprehension and recall of listening input. Now, top-down strategies. They are listener-based. How can we? It can be mentioned. It is based on listener-based condition only. The listener taps into background knowledge of the topic, the situation or context, the type of text. It is based on only the listener. It is based on only listener about the background, about the topic, about the contents, about the what we call as the situation. Understand? Based on only listener, based only we write this one. So top down strategies include, point number one, listening for the main idea. Student listen to identify the overall ideas expressed in the whole recording. That is very important. Overall ideas. Understand? What is the topic? What is the context? What type of procedure is giving? So it is fully based on to the overall ideas only. Now, predicting gets your students to predict the content of a listening activity beforehand. They all try to guess . So the point number four, get your students to predict the content of a listening activity beforehand. They all try to guess key information contained in the recording before the listen. Understand? Summarizing,
So total what you listen, you summarize what is the theme, topic, content, message. So all these things should be summarized. The sixth one is identifying emotion. Students listen to identify the mood of certain speakers. Mood of the certain speakers. Listening for opinions. Listening for opinions. Now, first case we saw top up strategies, top down strategies. Now, bottom up strategies. They are text based. First one is listener based. Now, their second category is text based. Second category is text based. First one is listener based. Remember, students, please remember, the listener relies on the language in the message, that is the combination of sounds, words and grammar that create meaning. Okay, it should be note that the communication of sounds, words, grammar that creates meaning. Bottom up strategies include, what are they? Listening of specific detail. Okay, it should be very detailed. What are they? Student listen for groups of words and phrase it at sentence level. So students must listen for group of words, okay, and phrases and sentence level. So listening for specific details. Listening for specific details. Number second one is listening for specific information. Student listen for particular information at word level. Third one is recognizing word order pattern. First one is listening for specific details. Second one is listening for specific information. Third one is recognizing word order pattern. Activity. What is that? A children listen to their teacher. Some try to work out what is going on, while other choose to remain silent. So in the classroom activity or whatever it may be there, so what is going on? At what kind of activities going on there? That should be noted. As children listen to their teacher, first thing. Some try to work, whether it may be writing or any listening or speaking. What is going on while other chose to remain silent? Point number one, why do you think some children choose to remain silent when listening to their teacher? So one question is arise here in activity. Why do you think some children choose to remain silent when listening to their teacher? Is it not? The second question, why do not some other children want to listen to what is being said to them? It is commonly happening. Why do not some other children want to listen to what is being said to them? So two things here. So why do you think some children choose to remain silent? You ask him to silent, keep silence, listen what the teacher is telling to him. Similarly, why do not some other children want to listen? Children are not to listen what is being said to them. Instruction in how to teaching listening. Step 1, international modification of language. During interaction between people in any language, there are communications breakdown, that is misunderstanding. The first one is international modification of language during interaction person to person, or a teacher to their student, or a employee to that employer to the boss, whatever may be that. So during interaction between people and any language, there are communication breakdowns. So what will happen? Misunderstanding takes place. However, if the misunderstanding is serious, the partner will decide to repair and rephrase by modifying the original language used, and is often what is called language modification. If it is the communication gap, the communication breakdown, if it is misunderstanding, definitely the opposite person, the partner, will repair and rephrase, the modifying the original language use, and this often what is called language modification. So totally he modified the language. Examples of language modification. Example number one is using repetitions. So he is avoiding, instead of that, he is using the same sentence, the same message, the same principle, 2 or 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, repeating, going on repeating. So that also language modification. Number two is comprehension checks. Do you understand what I am trying to say? Hello, gentleman, do you know what I am going to say? Please try to understand. Please, hello, do you understand what I am trying to say? Like that. Clarification request. What did you say? What you want to say? Please tell me in detail. I can't understand. Like that, he will be modify the languages. Step 2, ask students to demonstrate listening by predicting the end of a story. Ask students to demonstrate listening by predicting the end of story. Step 3, encourage students to listen for unfamiliar words and raise their hands to ask for definitions to increase their comprehension. So in generally, so I also request you to please read the newspapers, underline the new words by means of dictionary. You develop the new words, meanings, synonyms, so the and the definitions, what is what. Understand, this is the time. So you have no classes, please in the afternoon hours read the newspapers, underline the things which you do not understand and try to solve. So encourage students to listen for unfamiliar words and raise their hands to ask for definitions to increase their comprehension. You must ask. For example, if your teacher is asking unfamiliar words, and we have to ask, okay, you must ask, raise your hands, ask for the definitions. Step 4, play a record or tape recording of your students' songs, then quiz the students on the song after playing it for the classes. Step 7, play listening game like Simon Says or Hockey Pocky, varying your instructions so that the students have to listen closely to succeed. Anjum, with that I conclude my topic. Understand? So please go through this listening and speaking skills. Time permit, read the daily English newspapers, okay, English newspapers, small stories, so that you can develop your vocabulary and communication. So computer knowledge is also very important, as well as communication skill. So remember, English is a language and communication is a skill. So try to develop. Thank you, one and all. Thank you.